king refused the sacrifice.
No choice but to act purely on blind faith. There was no way to tell what error this device was tuned to, and I had neither the knowledge nor the means to set the machine myself. I hesitated only briefly. Then, throwing the switch, I hurled myself into oblivion and relinquished my will to the hand of fate. Beyond all hope and against all probability, it seemed that the device had unerringly delivered me to the error I sought. For these were Seraphim banners, and these vampires apparently the victims of their crusade. The coincidence seemed too convenient to naively ascribe to fate, but whether my opportune arrival had been orchestrated by Mobius or some other influence, I didn't know. If Janos Ordrin still lived, I would find him. But I was wary of further deception and resolved to tread carefully. Thank you. For all the butchery of Mobius's crusade, this massacre was somehow more chilling. The killing fields of the Seraphim betrayed a kind of orderly ruthlessness, the cold-blooded righteousness of the true believer.
That is holy.
Here at last, in the flesh, I beheld my former brothers in arms, the warrior priests of the Seraphim Order, their lives devoted solely to the annihilation of the vampire plague. And while I confess, I felt a twinge of longing, a pang of grief for what I had believed was my lost virtue, I regarded them now with none of the reverence I formerly felt. For I had seen the human face of the vampires, and now I beheld the monstrousness of these men.
Oh!
Thank you.